The electrical components inside enclosures that house industrial automation systems like PLCs often operate on a 24-volt power supply. So in these enclosures, we usually need one or several power supplies that each have a 24-volt output voltage. But in some applications, where ultra-reliability is essential, and an unexpected loss of power would be disastrous, we need to use redundant power supplies. For instance, each of these enclosures that you see here is going to be used to control and monitor the parameters of gas turbines in one of the biggest oil refineries in the world. So in order to provide the necessary power for electrical components, we have used a set of redundant power supplies. In this video, we're going to learn exactly how these types of power supplies work from a practical perspective. Okay, so we have a set of redundant power supplies in this enclosure. As you can see, each of them has a set of terminals here. The lower terminals are used to connect the input power. This is usually a 110 or 220 volt AC supply. So we can turn on the power supplies by connecting AC power to the input. First, we connect AC power to these terminals. The power will travel through wires that are routed through these wire ducts. The wires terminate in a connection to the input terminals of the power supplies. However, this input power is not directly connected to the power supplies, and as you can see, we have used a series of protective devices such as surge protection, a harmonic filter, and fuses before the power supplies. This yellow wire here is the ground wire. So to turn on the power supply, we connect a 110 or 220 volt AC power here. These upper terminals are the output terminals. When we connect AC power to the input terminals, it gives us a 24 volt DC voltage here. We can access the output voltage through these two red and blue wires that are connected to the output terminals. So these two wires are the input AC power, and these two are the 24-volt DC output. In addition to the output voltage, another important parameter of power supplies is the current rate. The current rate of each of these power supplies is 5 amps, as you can see here. This shows the actual capacity of these power supplies. It means that the maximum current that each of them can supply at the output is 5 amps. The more current the electrical devices within the enclosure draw, the higher the current rate of the power supply needs to be. Okay, now let's see how they work. Here, each power supply is capable of powering the entire enclosure, but by setting the output voltage of the primary supply 0.2 volts higher than the backup supply, only the primary supply delivers current to the load. With this setting, if the primary supply's output voltage decreases by more than 0.2 volts for any reason, the priorities are reversed, and only the backup supply delivers the load current. So let's test this on a practical level. While both of the power supplies are operating, we are going to remove this terminal in order to cut the input power of the primary supply. With the terminal removed, the primary supply is not working anymore, and the backup supply is operating and supplying the load current. Now, how does this happen? The outputs of these power supplies are interconnected through a diode switching arrangement. This diode can detect a fault, isolate the primary supply from the system output, and then pass only the output of the other supply with no interruption of output power during the transition. So the diode is a key element for operating these two power supplies as a redundant system. If we had two normal power supplies without an internal diode, we can use an external redundant module that is designed especially for this kind of application in order to make the two supplies operate as a redundant system. So there are two methods of utilizing redundant power supplies: using power supplies with internal diodes and using normal power supplies with an external redundant module. Okay, within each of these power supplies we see here, there is also an open contact, which closes whenever the power supply fails. We've connected the two ends of this contact to the PLC input, so that when the contact closes, a signal will be sent to the PLC to let us know about the problem. Now we replace the input terminal, and as you can see, normal operating conditions are restored. Okay, so in this video, we learned when to use redundant power supplies, and we also conducted a practical test of the operation. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. That way the videos come right to you. In addition, if you like this, if you find it useful, we appreciate the like. And if you've got comments, you want to add something, write it right down there, in the comments there in YouTube. We interact with people down in the comments, and we really do try to improve. We try to listen to what you're saying, so that we can make better content for you.